These chimps are pioneering apes. They live at the hottest extreme of any chimpanzee's range. And their home is getting hotter. We spent weeks on the savannah with them. And of all the animals we filmed in this series, it was spending time with the chimps that really stood out. We fell in love with these guys, just like primatologist Jill Preetz did 22 years ago. Despite the intense heat, she still never tires of hanging out with her Fongoli chimps.
I still feel really happy, like giddy, when I see them. There's always something new going on. Yeah, I still get a buzz.
What stands out when you're with the chimps is to have, you know, biological adaptations to dealing with heat.
These chimps are a bit different from their forest cousins. They look less hairy, and they walk upright more than chimps elsewhere in Africa. The more you look, the more it feels like you're watching a chapter of our own evolutionary history.
When I imagine early humans, this is kind of what I see. The habitat had a large influence on our own evolution. The same types of pressures must have been impacting them. This type of environment is very similar to what our first bipedal ancestors lived in.
After filming with the chimps for the first episode of the series, Jill told us there was more to this story. A new behavior never filmed before.
They're just here.
And we should stay and see if we could film it with remote cameras. It's behavior other chimps don't do. And it only happens here when it gets hot. I mean, really hot. When it gets to be like 107, 110, it doesn't matter whether it's a wet heat or a dry heat. It's just hot. As the mercury rises in the dry season, it feels like the chimps are at a breaking point. The heat stress falls hardest on mama and her baby.
Females that have young infants that are nursing are going to be stressed. You know, you want out of the sun.
The pressure of the extreme heat pushes these chimps to do something extraordinary. Other chimps will not do this. Caves like this, that's where predators hide out. They could get cornered in here. They must rewire years of instinctual fear to become indoor chimps. And our remote cameras were there to capture it. Mama and baby finally get some respite from the midday sun. She heads even deeper into the cave, crawling into a chamber beyond the overhang.
Females that are nursing and really stressed by heat will be hanging around the cave. The caves are consistently cooler.
And when she says cooler, she means an astonishing 23 degrees cooler than outside. And everyone wants a piece of this action.
If there are a lot of chimps around, the adult male, they'll actually compete over access to the caves.
It's still early days to start describing this cave behavior, but this is what I would categorize as chillaxing. When the afternoon cools off, it's time to head back to the plains. These chimps are on the front line of our warming planet. They are experiencing an environment changing 10 times faster than our ancestors did 5 or 6 million years ago. What's more, the changes now are happening faster than any other time in the past 65 million years. Jill's working out what all this means for the future of her Fongoli chimps.
It seems like the chimps could exist up until the year 2080.
After that, the rise in temperature means there likely won't be enough water.
At that point, the chimps couldn't survive.
Not even the caves would help. And who knows where they would move to then? As our planet warms, every creature, including us, we'll need to find new ways to cope.